Which side would you prefer, this one or this one? I'm easily gonna go with this slide right here just because of all the illustrations that are added on the presentation. So in this video, I'm gonna show you guys how to add epic illustrations to your PowerPoint presentation. So without further ado, let's get started. All right, so as you can see here on my screen, I have this original slide that I was showing you right here. Now, a thing that I wanna show you guys is this slide right here and how I came about making it and also how you guys can make something similar. So this is how you can easily add epic illustrations to your PowerPoint presentation. If you go up here in this illustration section, you're gonna see a thing called shapes. So I can click down on this drop-down arrow and it's gonna show me all my recently used shapes. So this is gonna look different for you based on what you choose for recently used shapes. But these are what I always use in my PowerPoint presentations. And then it's going to show you all these different types of lines, rectangles, basic shapes, block arrows, equations, flowcharts, you get the gist. So there's a bunch of different shapes that you can pick here. And these are just a couple of quick ways to spice up your slide so that it's not just boring text on your slide. If I were to pick a shape based on what I have here on slide two, what I would do is I would go here to shapes and I would insert this circle right here. And then I would make it like so. And then I would make it around that size. And then what I did for the styling is I right clicked and went to format shape, pops open this window right here. And then I added a gradient. And then also I added a drop shadow right here. So that is just a quick way of how I styled a circle. And then what you see here is a bunch of these icons. So if you go back to insert, you're gonna see a section called icons. So if I click on icons, it's then going to pop up a window for you to see a bunch of awesome looking icons that you can pick through. Now this tool doesn't have every icon in the world, so you might not always find what you want, but it does have several options for most use cases, which is nice. So let's say I wanted to add in a cookie for some odd reason. I could type in cookie and now it's going to give me a gingerbread man or a fortune cookie. I'm surprised they don't include chocolate chip cookies because those are my favorite, but that's okay. So let's say we were wanting to include this fortune cookie. I can click on it and then say insert. And now it's going to insert that icon easily for you. And then you can make it white and then you can enlarge it and decrease it, you know, position right here, change the coloring of it to be maybe like this color. And then you could add that in your circle right here. So that's an easy way on how you can add icons to your slide. So let's say you add in your shapes, you add in your icons, and now you want to really liven up your presentation. Well, what you can do is you can add in this feature called 3D models. So if I go up here to 3D models and then click on from online sources, it's then gonna load up a screen of a bunch of different 3D models that you can add in on your PowerPoint presentation. Now, I haven't seen this used a whole lot in PowerPoint presentations, but this is an option for you just in case you do wanna take your PowerPoint presentation to another level. What's really cool that they have in here that's kind of in the newer versions of PowerPoint is that if you click in here, you're gonna see a bunch of different animated objects. So let's say I want to include this dinosaur. I can click on this, insert. And now as you can see here, I have this moving object, which is super cool. So I could actually have this object like eat this astronaut if I wanted to, or maybe if I wanted to eat this planet, I could do that. And it's just a really cool way to spice up your slides. So let me know in the comments down below if you do want me to go more in depth on 3D models, but just know that it's a really cool feature. It's somewhat new, but feel free to play around with it. It really can liven up your PowerPoint presentations. Also note that they can be a little distracting, so just be careful with that if you are having an actual moving object 3D animation. There's also other options to insert. Let's say I go from online sources and I pick, let's see here, we could do emojis and we put in this happy face. So if I insert this, it's really not going to be moving around, but it can rotate to however angle you want. You can include that in there. Why you'd want to include that, I'm not sure. You could also, if you just click on this center thing, this is how you can actually rotate. So that's how I'm rotating it. And then they do have this drop down arrow if you want to select which position you want to have it at right here as well. You can also do a bunch of different like pan and zoom features. So you can really customize how to do these 3D models. And let me know again if you do want me to do a tutorial in depth on how to do 3D models. So the next way on how you can also spice up your slides is, let's say you want to add in smart art. Now, do I personally use SmartArt? Not really. I like to kind of create my own SmartArt styles. So I'm gonna show you guys what I mean by this. So let's say you have a list. You can pick different SmartArt here. So let's say I like this, hit okay. And then it's gonna pre-populate this design for you. So if you don't have a good eye for design, or you just don't know how to build out maybe an infographic style of information, this is a quick workaround for you to use. I personally don't like it because sometimes it's hard to edit these and move them around to how I'd like. And it just kind of restricts me a little bit. So I like to design my own type of SmartArt, but just know this is an option for you. They also do have SmartArt styles here for you to pick from. You can always reset the graphic if, let's say, you picked it like this. You didn't like that, you want to go back to the original, reset it, and then it'll go back. You can also move down or up. So if you had information that originally was first, but now it needs to be second, that is a way to do it. And there's just a bunch of different layouts. So it's not a terrible tool. It works great if you need to just get something with the job done. But I do like to kind of customize my own SmartArt just cause. So just know this is an option for you. They have a bunch of different options too. Other than lists, they have processes, cycles, hierarchy. You can see all the lists here, but it's a really cool tool to explore just in case you do want to get help on how to visually portray that information. All right, so the last thing I want to show you guys is charts. So let's say you have a bunch of information. Let's say it's about like budgeting or finances, whatever it may be. You can click on charts and it's kind of going to do the same thing that SmartArt did, but for charts and information. So let's say you need a column chart or a line chart or a pie chart. Maybe you're showing like, you know, how much people ate this type of pizza versus another type of pizza. You can include this and then choose the styling you want. And then once you like that styling, you can hit okay. All right, so now it's gonna load up this screen right here, and it's basically going to allow you to insert your information. So this is just what I had as a demo for my last explanation on this, but it's just showing first, second, third, fourth quarter as if you were like a company and then sales. So you can obviously change these numbers to however you want, and then you can change these colors. So you can really customize charts. If you do want an in-depth tutorial on how to do charts, definitely let me know in the comments down below. But this is just another quick way to add visuals to your slides instead of just plain text. All right, so that's everything in the illustration section in PowerPoint. If you guys did find this video helpful, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you could subscribe, I would greatly appreciate it. It's free to do, so please do that. Also, if you are interested in learning more about PowerPoint, I do have a course on Udemy, so I'll have a link to that in the description below. But without further ado, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I hope to see you guys in future videos. Thanks.